Why don't wish for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only bitch I'm confused.
Fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Two teams here fresh off week one victories. Who can keep it going as we're underway on EA Sports?
Fielded in the end zone.
Getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27.
27-yard line.
Touchdown on the season, and the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown? And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. Taken about 7 yards deep.
Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. And this is incomplete. Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze. He gets this one complete to Traquan Smith. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a 3rd and a couple remaining. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. 2 yards and able to get the first down in the process.
First and 10 at the 35-yard
line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Throwing now is Breeze. He's got his all-time receiver, Michael Thomas. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Smith catches left side. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
For a Saints.
I like watching. watching the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit, but how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
From midfield, here's Breeze. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Tre'Quan Smith, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down, that leads to a second and 10. Now, Breeze again. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
They'll take over first down.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. A good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Now the throw pulled in by Anderson. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield.
A loss of a yard brings up fourth down.
They're going to look to throw. Going left side here, and it's complete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. Inside the 15 before they drop it. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. It's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. It's Patrick Robinson there on the stop.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
A second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. Third down here. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and 8.
8 yards to go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
That pick hurts a little extra because it was third down. You were already in field goal range.
You know what he's going to hear all night, all next week? Situational football. Understand what's going on, because you expressed it perfectly. 3 points were in their hip pocket. They had those. Now those went by the wayside. You cannot make those kind of mistakes.
It's what you call a rookie mistake.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Shotgun now for Breeze. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Yetur Gross-Matos. In there to get him. It's a loss of 5. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Finding Harris over the middle. And he'll go out of bounds.
yards after getting this across the 15. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
Fourth down.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They're going to run it with Murray. And he will get the first down as he's up to the 20-yard line. It'll be a three-yard gain, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
With the score, Panthers 7, Saints nothing.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. From the gun, it's Breeze. Incomplete. Crisis averted.
Breeze.
Almost picked. Instead, second down.
Incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Breeze again here on second and 10. His throw is incomplete.
Nowadays, quarterbacks don't mind throwing into coverage because of the confidence they have in their receivers to come down with the ball. But sometimes you have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. Complete, and he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara, and able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
One-yard gain brings up second and 9.
On second and 9, Breeze. Escaping the pressure right. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. Second down. So maybe just a momentary setback on what's been a great drive so far, but second and 13 here. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Right, and that's complete.
Breeze.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Oh, look at that, a diving catch. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
And not all spectacular catches are the result of a pass that maybe was not thrown quite right. Sometimes it's thrown in the perfect spot, and you have to just go get it. And he did that right there.
No fear there in the middle of the field. Looking long for Thomas. Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it, lost it there. And it'll be second down.
Michael Thomas, incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball who just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Again, they'll throw with Breeze.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
So you're a boxing guy. How do you score that on your boxing card? A very long drive with 3 points.
And I really want to do my boxing analyst voice right here, but I'm going to keep it normal for us, right? I called a draw. That type of a drive has to feel good, right? You take it all the way downfield, you control the ball, control the clock. But they only got 3 points out of it. So defensively, it could have been worse, right? So I give it a draw.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
And a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Rookie to rookie on the hook up there, and it's a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. To it, he did on the dive. Nice grab. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. It's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one? A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And able to get this one across the 35 before he's brought down. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. On first down, Breeze. Oh, that was dangerous. Breeze threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
It's second down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Not a whole lot of room to maneuver there, and I think that's because everyone took care of their responsibilities, filled their gaps, held their place. No place for him to run.
Yeah, looked good. Everything got funneled to the nose tackle. He swallowed him up. That's caught inside the 20. That time. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Into the red zone. It's Breeze. Looking for Thomas. He's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. His second touchdown on the season. And the Saints have taken the lead. And he knocks it through.
Makes the score Saints 10.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. You're down three, under a minute to go. How aggressive are you going to be in this spot?
Not as aggressive as I probably would want to be.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of. The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, get that water break and get on out there and play.
Looking deep downfield. And incomplete. An excellent play downfield. Should have been picked off, really. But second down instead. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Breeze. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be out right at the 35. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Throwing on first down is Breeze. He's going to go for a big play downfield. This is caught inside the 15. He is in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there as the first half is winding down. And the Saints have retaken the lead. What's good on the extra point? And it's now 17-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Now we're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
Open man is Robbie Anderson. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone.
Incomplete in the end zone. Brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. They'll throw now on the final play. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 18. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. you've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
That'll toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. ...13 yards remaining on second down. Breeze now. And it's caught on the right side at Smith. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
That's a gain of 7. Makes it 3rd and 7.
Now Breeze on 3rd down. Incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up 4th down. So Breeze is going to stay out there, and they're going to go for this on 4th down. They'll go for it. It's Breeze. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Decision to go for it backfires, and the Panthers will get the football back. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. 3rd and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. 3 tight ends, and he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
8 yards.
1st and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. And they give this time to the tailback. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Now he'll pull it down. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation. And for the Saints here on 3rd down, an extra defensive back on the field. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. They'll pass up a field goal attempt. It would have been a 45-yarder. Now they'll go for it on 4th. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And that is going to be incomplete. The Panthers turned away on 4th down. And the Saints will have the football back.
The result of the play is a turnover on downs.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they've got the lead here getting late into the 3rd quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that. But the rushing game, almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off, they need the running game to come back to life. They need to get sparked that way.
take some time off the clock, and keep the ball away from their opponents.
Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
A give. This is Kamara. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They'll let this go for the end zone. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Breeze here finding Kamara, and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 yards there, first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
He's got the first down inside the 10, and finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Breeze to throw again. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. There's that man again. It's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll make it third and goal.
Ready. 95-56.
Now, Breeze again. Look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off down at the 2. And a great return as he takes us up just shy of the 45. Whatever's going on between his ears right now. It's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Let's face it, that's just a helpless feeling for a running back there. He's looking up to find a hole, and all he finds is a whole lot of ticked off linebacker.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll set up a throw. Flushed out right. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is third and inches. this run defense has been pretty stout all game long. Now you're here in the fourth quarter. Rely more on the passing attack?
I don't think you have any choice, and I don't think you have to dress it up at all either. Throughout the first three quarters, you're still trying to convince the defense that you may run the football. That's out the window right now. Protect, let your quarterback operate, and try and find some targets in the open field downfield.
Now the throw pulled in by Anderson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Bobby Anderson.
A good pickup there, 21 yards. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme. When you have a blocker on a defender and the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. They're going to run this with a tight end. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. Just a yard, but that's all they needed. And by the slimmest of margins, it'll be 1st and goal. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A touchdown is paramount here on 1st and goal, but got to be careful. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Panthers have taken the lead here in the 4th. It's up and good to make it 21-17.
Makes the score Panthers 21, Saints 17.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get them down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once it threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's all we can get done.
You can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
Down 4 late. Got to go for it here on 4th down. Back to throw, Breeze. Such little time remaining, and the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. The Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation.
Yeah.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
He was brought down at the 26. A 3-yard pickup. And it's third down.
So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Panthers, it's a dream start. 2 wins in 2 early road games. And they will head home next week to take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup with the Falcons. So for...
for the wins, came in a drop on a 10, now we on top once again, yeah, I had to tighten the plan, yeah, I got it right in the end, ay. Now we on top once again, I don't want it if it ain't love, if it ain't get it away from me, who you gonna jack if it ain't us, LABB to the bakery, some mad that I came up, I know my granny gonna pray for me, it was just us in the vacancy, we had to get it from A to B, wheels never felt like this, 2 seats, every single time, feel righteous, blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless, new keys can't care what's built private, I might just double it up, did it, never enough, I'm with it, 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins in the world suspended, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was pop. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go to it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You better so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top yeah. Once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10.